as all the skaters that are meddling, of course, are quite thrilled right now to be out there and be celebrating after this fun weekend. And we go to the floor.
Gentlemen, if we can have your attention, please, down here. We've got some beautiful hardware to give out and a nice MVP package. And I believe that we're being joined now by an international audience on WFTDA.tv. So say hi to everybody watching at home. After that, we're going to seed the championship tournament now that we know who all 12 participants are. But before we do it, how about those last couple of games, ladies and gentlemen? Unbelievable, am I right? And how about our hosts, the Omaha Roller Girls? Do they know how to put on a tournament or what? I'm announcer Dwayne Cunningham, tournament head announcer, but now I would like to turn it over to our representative from the WFTDA Board of Directors, Amy Spears.
I want to thank you all for being a part of the WFTDA's 10th tournament season. On behalf of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association's Board of Directors, I'd like to start by thanking the Ralston Arena and all the fans who've joined us here and online at WFTDA.tv.
And we want to remind you that this tournament was made possible in part by our valued sponsors, including Rydell Skates, Derby Supply, Adam Skates, Fast Girl Skates, Bont, S1 Helmets, and Green Monster Roller Sports.
Green Monster.
We'd also like to thank all of our many, many staff and volunteers who put on such an excellent tournament, but especially our officials crew led by Sir Osis and Nine Inch Wheels. Games tournament oversight led by Carmageddon. The Rinkster team led by John Obst. I would personally love to thank the excellent announcer crew that I was so lucky to have on my hands this week, that we were so lucky to have on our hands this week. Some old friends that go all the way back to the beginning of this thing, and some brand new friends who I can't wait to work with again on that crew. We also greatly appreciate the work of our marketing team, keeping everyone up to date in social media land, and our on-site sponsorship representative, Taco Cat. Big thanks to our photographers for making everybody look great, which for some of us is a tougher job. Blaze Streaming Media and the WFTDA.tv broadcast crew, led by Double H. And of course, our medical support staff and volunteers. Yeah. Yeah. Give him a clap. Last but not least, certainly not least, we'd like to extend a huge thank you to our hosts, the Omaha Roller Girls. Thank you to every one of you wearing those green and white shirts this weekend. You are absolutely perfect. And a special thanks to Southern Discomfort and Sharon Misery for leading such an incredible pool of staff volunteers. Thank you, thank you, thank you. On behalf of the WFTDA, we'd like to extend our congratulations to all of the leagues that participated in this week's tournament. The Angel City Derby Girls, the Boston Derby Dames. Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Our friends from Helsinki. Helsinki Roller Derby. The Minnesota Roller Girls. Montreal Roller Derby. The No Coast Derby Girls. The Queen City Roller Girls. Toronto Roller Derby. And the Windy City Rollers. Such a hard-fought tournament by every single participant. But it's time for one of them to be named the tournament MVP. And for that, I hear some predictions out there. For the answer, I turn you back to Amy Spears.
It's my honor to introduce the tournament MVP. Each MVP is chosen by the WFTDA Board of Directors, both here on site and watching from home. As a player who embodies the WFTDA values by being a real, strong, athletic, and revolutionary individual both on and off the track. These characteristics include being a leader, a powerful skater voice, an amazing athlete, and an inspiration within the roller derby community and in our sport. This year's MVP has been a critical part of her team's defense for several seasons, serving as the anchor of absolutely devastating packs. This weekend, while she was on the track, her team's jammers got leads 70% of the time and outscored their opponents by a combined total of 552 points. The 2015 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs Omaha Tournament MVP is Sexy Slady. Sexy Slady, everybody, give her a big hand. The tournament MVP prize package is presented by Rydell Skates. It includes a gift certificate from Rydell in the amount of $599. Good toward any Rydell boots, Powerdyne plates, radar wheels, or quick bearings.
Minnesota is going back for the fifth time since.
Ladies and gentlemen, the third place team in this tournament is going home to champs. Going to champs for the sixth time since 2010, I think fifth time. Ladies and gentlemen, the Minnesota Roller Girls! Even got one from Minnesota. Minnesota, the name of that mascot, in case you're unaware.
Yep, sort of. I see.
The second place team from the Omaha playoff tournament, going to champs. Played a hard fought weekend, took more points in the game against their opponent than anybody else did against that opponent this year. And they are firing on all cylinders, headed to Minnesota. Ladies and gentlemen, Angel City! And ladies and gentlemen, heading to Minnesota, the most dangerous roller derby team of all time, looking for their fifth Hydra in a row, looking possibly better than ever this year. Ladies and gentlemen, Gotham Girls Roller Derby!
Happy birthday.
Thanks, Yeah.
Thank you. Way to go. Good work. That's great stuff. Yep. Excellent work. Congratulations on that, too. Yep. Excellent tournament. Fantastic. See you, y'all.
All right, so ladies and gentlemen here in the venue, and those of you watching at home on WFTDA.tv, we're going to take a few pictures. Those of you tuning in online, do not switch off. We're going to cut to a few commercials. And those of you in-house as well, here in just a few moments, Double H is going to join me, and we're going to determine who plays who in November in Minnesota. Stick around. Seeding the bracket for champs, coming right up.